This week, the Upstate is hosting the Food for Thought Conference. It's bringing business leaders from all walks of life together to exchange ideas and get re-inspired, basically. Now, one of the A-list speakers at the conference, this guy right here, Warren Brown, he's with us right now. As you can see, he's been on the Food Network and also basically founder of Cake Love.
That's right.
Tell us about Cake Love. And before, before we get into that,
you're
a baker. But before you got into baking, you were you were a lawyer. You worked in health fraud litigation.
Right.
So you went from being a lawyer to a baker. How in the world did you do that?
For me, I was at the desk working, doing all the briefs and filings for the court, but I spent a lot of time surfing the web looking up recipes. And I had an interest in baking, wanted to learn how to do that, and I said to myself, eventually, you got to make a choice between practicing law and following your passion, following what you really care about. And so after a number of different things that happened that made me make a decision, I chose cakes, and I'm happy about it.
Well, obviously, it was financially rewarding for you, but when you go from a lawyer to, say, a baker, I mean, I would think the first question is, gosh, am I going to be financially successful at this?
Oh, I ask myself that every day, basically, In the beginning, I was terrified of whether or not I would make it and then have enough success so that I could pay the bills and keep the business running. But, 10 years ago is when I started all this. And the Cake Love has grown so that there are 7 locations, and I've written 2 books, and I've had a wonderful experience along the way that I wouldn't ever trade in.
Now, your shops are called Cake Love.
That's right.
And you say that you basically put love into everything you bake.
We do.
We say that, the people who actually cook, they say that, but I don't cook, as you can tell. But what does that mean, putting love into what
I asked
you do?
Myself that a lot, because people said, oh, you have to put love into the baking and the cakes, otherwise it won't taste good. And it's not a special ingredient, but I think it's a special way of approaching the baking. And that means to me, we don't cut corners. We bake the old-fashioned way. We use ingredients that have real small words, so it's not like something that's fake and artificial. You know, we want to bake the way that your grandmother did. And at Cake Love, we do that every day on site from scratch. And to me, that's a lot of what the love is that's, tangible. And it makes something that just tastes delicious.
Obviously, you're one of the inspired speakers chosen this week.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun speaking there.
Oh, I'm sure it has been. So what would you say to someone who's thinking about maybe changing careers, getting out of a job that they make decent money, and they can continue making decent money, but it's not their passion?
I think that the choice is always going to be difficult when you want to leave one career for another. But if there's a calling that's inside of you, an itch that's in you, and burning desire to do and work in a different direction, you have to answer that at some point. You just won't be able to get through life without reconciling with what's inside of you. And that inner voice can't be ignored. For me, it came early on, and I had a really clear indication that I had to pursue cakes. It's different for every person, and that's good because, our country and community needs different types of jobs and stuff. I think that people that don't listen to what's inside of them, that's burning to get out, can be unhappy.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if you're not happy, I know there's lots of things that can make people unhappy. If you're not happy, then it's up to you to take the first steps to get out and get into a different place.
Yeah.
And it's not easy. It's not easy at all. And one thing I cringe when I hear other people who are entrepreneurs who talk about the tough times they had, and it's just like one sentence. I mean, let me tell you, man, that stuff is hard to make it work.
Yeah.
Blood, sweat, and tears.
Yeah.
But it can, and everyone can get there, I think.